Hi, I'm Javier Bolaños here in Rio de Janeiro. You may know that the Summer Olympic Games will begin here in 2 weeks, but the truth is almost nobody here seems to be really happy about that. A recent poll said half of the Brazilians are opposed to hosting the Olympics, and 63% believe the Games will bring more costs than benefits. The economic, social, and political situation facing Brazil and Rio have changed drastically since 2009, when this city won the right to host the 2016 Games. A huge corruption scandal resulted in investigations into dozens of high-ranking politicians and members of the business elite. President Dilma Rousseff is being impeached for covering gaps in the government's budget in ways that are said to be illegal. And by the way, a group of evangelical congressmen had a crucial role denouncing that corruption scandal. And now the provisional president, Michel Temer, is asking not only advice with these Christian congressmen, but also asking for their prayers. But the country's economy has also fallen. Its gross domestic product dropped by 3.8% last year alone. The state of Rio de Janeiro is broke, and the federal government is not in great shape either. Teachers and the police have their salaries delayed. Inflation is on the rise, and so is crime. The state security budget has been cut. Plus, there is the Zika virus, which has hit Brazil really hard. The virus had some public health officials calling for the games to be canceled, and a handful of athletes have declined to participate. You know, cities that hold Olympics rarely break even on the games. But in Rio's case, it won't be even close. Brazil originally budgeted more than $14 billion to hold the Olympics, money that would be spent on infrastructure, stadiums, transportation improvements, the Olympic Village, and so on. That number is now estimated at about $20 billion. Thousands of people who live in favelas, that's how they call the slums here, have been ousted from their homes, often relocated hours from their schools and job, only to make the way for the needs of the Olympics. But all that Olympic construction has not been enough to stem the decline of Rio's economy. So the games will go on, and for those watching on TV, of course, it'll be a great show. Most of the Olympics will take place in kind of a bubble separated from the city's problems. But after the games end on August 21st, the world will go on, will move on, and the people of Rio will stay here trying to cope with all those problems. So stay tuned to CBN News for more reports on the preparation for the Olympic Games. I'll be showing you how the church here is making a difference, using all these bad circumstances to reach people for the Lord Jesus Christ. This is Javier Bolaños reporting from Rio de Janeiro for CBN News.